Hello and greetings from Iceland. This update will be short, since I'm in Reykjavik now, so the sound recording might suffer a bit. And I actually came yesterday, drove straight to the Blue Lagoon, and did a thermal scan there to see how things would look from the drone. And before I show you that, let's see what has been going on. Yesterday started actually with a rather strong earthquake swarm just by the Blue Lagoon. And soon thereafter, experts confirmed it to be magma on the move at 3 to 4 kilometers depth, centered around here, under those crossroads. But many of yesterday's earthquake did actually take place here by the mountain Thorbjörn, and that is where we are getting very, very close to the Blue Lagoon. It would have been nice to relax there yesterday after a lot of work and driving, but I felt as I could pick a better time for that. So let's check the thermal video. It was pitch black when I was filming, so I will be using this overview photo. And I started to scan where yesterday's earthquake took place. At the north side of Thorbjörn, there is actually a thick layer of old lava there all around. And this experiment of mine was all about to see whether if heat could be detected coming up from some of the fractures in the ground as an indication where the next eruption would take place. The thermal drone is extremely sensitive. This is the Blue Lagoon from 500 meters away, and the thermometer is getting the water temperature there pretty much right, even though it's not supposed to do it from this distance. And the first thing I noticed on Mount Thorbjörn was this, telling me how necessary it is to do some practice, because those are trees storing some of the heat, since it was sunny that day. But this was, however, shot after sunset. The outside temperature was 3 degrees Celsius, and it was very windy. And when I was flying directly over the epicenter, where the land uplift takes place, I started to see some anomalies, like on this spot, 16 degrees Celsius and 7 to 9 degrees rather widespread. So it is no doubt in my mind that the ground there is unusually hot. But is it due to this land uplift and the magma intrusion? Some of those spots might have been there before. And that is why I felt it as necessary to take the thermal drone there right away after this started, or to help me with readings when the magma gets closer, map the area. So I actually came back with more questions than answers. And I did take screenshots from this video and sent it to the meteorological office that handles the monitoring system and the civil defense as well, but they have their own experts. And as for the general situation there, the aviation code has been placed on code yellow, and the civil defense declared a level of uncertainty a few days ago. It is no surprise that the people in Grindavík are getting worried, so tomorrow there will be an information meeting there with experts. And as things look now, with this location I was flying over yesterday, we got new INSAR images today confirming that location yet again as the epicenter, and if an eruption would come up there, the westernmost part of the town would be at risk. But it does, however, look worse for the Blue Lagoon and the power plant, especially the power plant, because it's situated in a depression in the land, and if we would lose the power plant under lava, we could actually handle the loss of electricity production there and use the grid to power up the town. But the hot water production that goes on there as well, that would be a serious problem. There are no backup systems there, and all houses in Grindavík are heated up with water from there. So to fix that is something that could take weeks or months. And even though we don't have any statistics, it looks as it's more likely than not that this will end up with an eruption. In fact, I've not seen so serious situation in Iceland as for infrastructure and volcanoes near inhabited areas since the eruption in Westman Islands in 1973, where 5,000 people were evacuated overnight. And what scares me the most about this location now is that an eruption there might not start friendly or gently, like the first three eruptions on the Reykjanes Peninsula. An Icelandic volcanologist was actually saying in the media 2 days ago that this could start with a lot of action or a large amount of magma coming up. in the first 24 hours. But of course, it depends on how much magma is there accumulating, so things are getting tense. But the Blue Lagoon remains open. They say they can evacuate the place within 2 hours. But I have to say that I have serious doubts about whether it's sensible to keep it open while things are so hectic, especially since we don't expect a friendly tourist eruption. And as for those who will be watching this, I do expect that webcams will be set up on the mountain Thorbjörn. I don't see them up and running yet, but it should be easy. And now when I'm finishing this upload, the earthquakes have moved to the Eldvörp crater row, so it is very obvious that the magma is just looking for the weakest part of the crust. So the earthquakes are all over the place, even though the epicenter is by the Blue Lagoon. So there is still a chance that the magma will just solidify and this will stop, like in December 2021, but I don't think so. And where the earthquakes are now, at the Eldvörp craters, that is in fact the best place for an eruption. From there, the lava would most likely flow into the sea. So if it's going to come up, let's hope it's going to be there. And finally, I want to thank my channel supporters for making it possible for me to do my reports 500 kilometers away from home. This is not easy at all, and it was not a good timing for me, but I managed to get here yesterday. Even though I had some car problems that I will try to fix while here in Reykjavík, but it is however a priority for me to cover this important part of this unfolding story. Since this is eruption number 4 that I will be covering, how I perceive it and cover it will hopefully be a part of a documentary later on. This is such a huge chapter in the history of Iceland that we are entering. Or as a volcanologist just said in an interview, the next 20-30 years, we might be seeing something like this every year. And we won't get lucky all the time for sure. So while I'm not doing my updates, I will be out capturing footage. But first and foremost now to see what the thermal drone sees. Since that information might be especially valuable. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.